Thank you for being here for Miss Stacy Dash in the house.
My name is Mark Johnson. I'll be collaborating the panel today with my very close sister, my producing partner, and my wonderful client, Stacy. We wanted to journey with you today and talk about, Stacy, your career in the industry, where you come from, what excites you, what inspires you, and where you're going from here. And so I want to start off by saying, you once said to me that people think you're actually Dion and grew up in Beverly Hills, and from what I understand, that is absolutely not the case.
Absolutely not the case. I'm from the South Bronx, and I grew up with two brothers and parents. So I had a very dysfunctional childhood, very often. I had to fight a lot, which I don't think Dion did. But in third grade, I played with Dan's mother in the play. And after that, I was like, that's it. This is it. I want to be an actress. I get to be someone else. I get to imagine the world. Thank you. I get to imagine the world and become that person. So, and back then you had to audition for a DJ. So you had to do a monologue. And I did a monologue, but to me, my first audition was for the Cosby Show. I booked it. And that was it. Next thing I knew, I was in a movie with Richard Pryor, a movie with David Wins, a movie with Mark Wahlberg. Favorite film I've done so far, and now, you know, I took a break for a while. I am going to be 7 years clean and sober. Thank you. So I took a break to focus on my recovery, and now I'm ready to go back. But there's a writer's strike, so you know, I'm like, no, what's going on? Stop.
There we go. you and Alicia are wrecking up on stage. It's like your high school kids all over.
I know, when we see each other, it's like the channel to us. It's amazing, we just love each other. We have this love for each other in that film. And I have to say, that is the only film that's happened where it's like the true versus bond. Yes. But again, it's Amy's genius. She put this together, so.
Fair. And you've been doing TikToks with Alicia, that charisma, that synergy continues today. Now let's talk a little bit, Stacey, about how old you were in that film, because I don't know a lot of people know, as a high school student on screen.
Yeah, I was actually 26, 27, because my son was
2-3 in the morning on set, and a lot of this was Brecken.
It was Brecken and Donald. They would make us laugh, and then they share, and we get so mad. They would come in and they were like, please, could you stop? Grow up! But we would have these giggle fits, and we would get drunk. Like, the director, the camera guy, the crew, we want to go home, and these actors would not stop laughing. Start the scene, and then just bust up. And the more trouble we got, the more people said stop laughing, the more we laughed. So I don't know if you know how that is from high school. The more the teacher told me to stop laughing, the more we told
me
to
stop.
Same thing.
Let's dive a little bit more into this, because it's such an iconic film from 1996, I believe. And to this day, new generations are coming to this film. We have little ones here at the Duke City Comic Con that are very moved when they see you sitting there and you get to meet you for the first time. And yet, Mom was a huge fan of her day. Well, you're crossing generations with this film.
I believe it will. It will continue. To me, it's like Gone with the Wind or Fast Time at Ridgemont High. It's just a film that's never going to die. The Godfather, my favorite film of all time. You know, it's just a film that's always there. It's
going
to be a classic. It's an epic classic film, and I feel blessed to have been a part of it.
And on the last note, if there was a reboot today, what would Sharon Dion be doing at an older age?
I think Dion would be a conservative,
like
magazine editor, and Sharon would be a stay-at-home mom. I'd be very liberal. But we'd still be best friends. And I'd have a daughter that was liberal, and she'd have a daughter that was conservative.
Now, obviously, acting is just one part of your shine. You're an author, a spokesperson, you've had many things in your journey. But where did the original inspiration to become an actress come from?
That play. Playing Mandy's mother. It was very traumatic. I died. You know? And, just God said, this is it. No matter what anybody told me, you can't do it, you're not going to do it, you know, blah, blah, blah. I was like, yeah, whatever, I'm doing it.
Now, what are some of the other interests that you have, Steve? So I know that interior design is
better for
you.
Yes, I'm an interior designer, and I'm a horse girl. I love horses. And so I ride quite a bit. And they're also good for people with PTSD, so I like to use them. And they're just the most majestic characters. And in fact, a fan painted these pictures of horses that I gave him today. I feel so blessed that he did that.
I believe an artist from Arizona who captures wild horses and paints them and brought that to you as a gift to
them. Yeah, my native partner with him, and my native name is Running Horse, so it was very, very. Thank you.
Eagles, I'd say one of the most popular comments is, "You're so beautiful, you haven't changed a day." What's it like for you when you come to these events?
I think
that's
so sweet. I don't mind aging. Being 56 is cool. And,
you don't look 56. You don't look 56 at all.
Sounds like I'm 33. My daughter's going to be 20 this week. So I don't mind. I think it gets better. Life gets better. So don't worry about it. Don't sweat. That's good.
Now you've had some great business experiences in your life as well. You're a business owner,
yes.
Fashion design.
Yes.
Tell us a bit about some of those.
I've had a line of lingerie. It's called Letters from Mark. It was in 75 stores around the world. We are working on improving it. I have a line of t-shirts, positive messages, Christian based. The lingerie was the biggest business in Denver. It was a huge success. So, 75 stores around the world. Harrods went into private label. So, and I love design. So, interiors, clothes, all that.
Design is a thing. Now, how about interacting with your fans? Because so many people have come up to you, compliments about the film that you've done, how stunning you are, your energy, standing in your truth, and speaking your truth is something you get quite often because you have chosen to stand in your power.
Yes.
Sounds good about that.
Well, I believe that everyone should. Everyone should have the right to believe what they want to believe and stand up. Not be judged. There should be no judgment. We should all be able to agree to disagree. And I'm just that person. I'm not afraid to say how I'm feeling, what I feel about things. And if you disagree with me, that's fine. I have no problem with that. But I'm not going to be forced into submission.
I think people would like to know, with some of your film work, where are some of the more favorite locations that you've shot?
Texas.
Mm-hmm.
Toronto.
Hey.
I hope I get to shoot in Vienna, Europe somewhere.
And what advice would you give young actors who are inspired to join the industry?
Make sure it is the only thing that you want to do. If there's no other choice to do it, it's because it's fun. And it can be, there's a lot of rejection. And you have to really believe in yourself. And it really has to be your passion. That's what I say. And study. Study to be an actress. Don't depend on social media numbers. You want your time.
Now you've been very active on social media as well. Your TikTok is blowing up. So I think some of the content you put out there, your voice to the world, really touches people, especially in the recovery space. When you speak your truth, Stacey, and you're on fire about what has saved your life and how you keep moving forward. We've seen many of the comments from around the world that say, because of you, I put down a bottle today, or I put down substance. How does that feel for you as a person?
It feels good, and that's what I'm here for. That's what the purpose is for me to be used by God to bring people to their best life. So to live a life of abundance while inspiring others to do the same. And I feel like the only way you can do that is by being authentic. And sometimes that's not pretty, right? But it's the truth. I'm human. Everybody else. It just happens to know my name.
Now, I know you have a very strong faith, and that's a big part of your recovery and a big part of your daily energy. And tell us a little bit about what you're doing.
Well, I am a Catholic, and Jesus is God is everything to me. He comes first. And I would say to everyone, if you're having any issues, any problems, depression, anxiety, because I've dealt with all of it,
in the industry a little bit too. He's a very clever entrepreneur. We were walking to the center of Comic-Con here, and the anime that's featured, that's where he started.
Obsessed with anime. In fact, he just, his father does a gaming, he owns a gaming company. My son just created a game, so excited about that.
Very cool.
Yeah.
Is that like an apple? Apple doesn't fall too far from the tree.
Clueless is the best one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I that just for those of us in the audience, what do you like people to leave with when they come and interact? Like, what do you hope for people?
I hope they feel inspired. I hope they feel strong in their purpose. Yeah. And they can achieve whatever they want to achieve. And they need to achieve the people that they want to achieve in their life. And they leave and they think, okay, I can do this, I can do this. Like I said, we're all just people. We just have our names.
Yeah.
That's it.
Thank you very much for an open-hearted conversation. That's coming to much. All right. Thank you very much, everybody. If you have any questions from the audience, you want to ask Stacey before we wrap up.
You mentioned Okinawan karate. Cobra Kai filming their final season. Have you maybe gotten in touch with them? Because that's all that's about.
Yeah.
I'm doing a rewatch of that right now myself. So yeah. Well, I like the back to the old school and all that.
Very good.
The 80s and such. Yeah.
Anyone else with a question for Stacey?
Yes.
What is like working with Ted Nelson? What's it like working with Ted Nelson?
Oh, yes, lovely. He was, during the Breakfast Club, right? Yes. I was like, oh my God, it's Ted Nelson from the Breakfast Club. Yeah. That was another time. Thank you for reminding me of that.
Right on. Any other questions from Stacey in the audience? Feeling good? Well, Stacey, thank you very much for the time. I'm going to be back signing autographs. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.